Turn on backyard floodlights. Hello guys, Life Hackster here. Today we'll check out the new products from Ring Smart Lighting. I got a hold of the Ring Solar Floodlight, their Solar Step Light, Solar Path Light, and also their Smart Light Bulb. Solar versions is a welcome update compared to their alkaline battery versions, which they released less than a year ago. I did review them then, and I will link those two videos in the description down below. But before we do the unboxing, I'll show you guys, while it is in daytime, what my plans are. And also take a look of my Ring Smart Lighting, which I have set up a while back. This is also gonna be an update for my Ring Smart Lighting. Let's start here in the front door. Currently, I've been using this for a while and has lit up my doorbell review videos at night. And this is my front porch light. I haven't made a review video on this, but this is a smart bulb from Walmart, Mercury brand, which uses the Genie app. It works okay, but I just set this to turn on at night and turn off during daytime. This is what my Ring Smart Bulb is going to replace, and for a couple of reasons. With Ring's bulb, I can link my Ring floodlight cam and also my Ring video doorbell so that after midnight, when they detect motion, it will turn on all the Ring smart lights in the front of the house, including this front porch light. Here at the steps leading to my door, I'll be installing the solar step light. I did have a battery step light which I was planning to install here before, but it never did happen. Going in my walkway, you will see my low voltage lighting which I bought from Lowe's. And they are connected to Ring Smart Lighting low voltage transformer. It has been working pretty good and no issues. Going a bit down, we have the battery path lights which still have been working okay. Batteries on both of them are still green and almost full. And it has been 9 to 10 months of use. The only thing is that I turned off motion notifications and only one of them is set to trigger the whole front group of lights when it detects motion. I'll keep using them for now. I have plans for the solar path light in my backyard and I only bought just one just to test out for now. So let's go to the backyard. You can also see here that I have some low voltage accent spotlights in the front of the house. I'll be showing you a night version of this walk around later on when everything is set up. Going to my side gate, you will see the smart motion sensor which I have set to notify me when it detects motion. I also have my solar light set up here, which I have made several videos of and I also linked them down below. Now I don't have my Ring's battery powered floodlight set up, and to be honest, it is because of the color of the light. I like my Mr. Beam's floodlight better because of the 5000 Kelvin white light instead of the warmer 3500 Kelvin soft light that Ring has been using. And this Mr. Beams has been working for me for more than a year now. And it is still pretty bright and I haven't replaced the batteries yet. I'm still debating on where I will place my new solar floodlight. And on the other side of the house is still my Ring Smart Lighting Spotlight, which is linked to my Ring Battery Spotlight Cam, which triggers it to start recording when this spotlight detects motion during daytime and at night. Let's do a quick unboxing. Let's start with the solar floodlight. It comes with a solar panel, and the ring bridge is required. I already have set up my ring bridge and you only need one bridge to control up to 50 of these smart lights. Ring states that only one bridge is supported per household. It uses a long-range RF signal to communicate with the smart lights. The bridge is basically a hub that connects Ring smart lights to the Ring app. This solar floodlight is motion activated and 1200 lumens. Opening the box, we have the usual paperwork. The floodlight itself, which has a total of 1200 lumens bright, much brighter than their 600 lumens battery powered one. We have the PIR sensor below the lights. On the back, the mounting plate is pre-installed to the light, and to remove it, just push the tab and slide it out. Turn the back cover to the unlocked position and you can open up the back. On the cover, there is a circular rubber plug that you can pull out to expose the solar panel port. The floodlight comes with a one rechargeable battery pack and has a slot for a second one. Push the tab to pull it out. What else is inside the box? We have the solar panel, which comes with a 14-foot cable with a barrel plug at the end, which connects to the port on the floodlight. We also have the solar panel mount, micro USB cable to charge the batteries, and mounting screws and plastic anchors. Let's move on to the solar path light, which the first thing I notice is that the solar panel is textured and is not shiny. We have the PIR motion sensor and the LED light that has a light output of 80 lumens, same as their battery version. Twisting the top will unlock and you will see the battery, which is an 18650 lithium-ion rechargeable battery with 3200 milliamp hour capacity. It also comes with a plastic stake to stake it to the ground and the plastic stand. We also have a charging cable, which there is a micro USB port close to the battery. Next is the solar step light, which is 50 lumens. The solar panel is the same textured design that is non-reflective. We have the PIR sensor in the front and the LED light pointing down. On the back side, we have the mounting plate already installed. Just push it down to remove it. Pull up on the tab to open the back, exposing the battery, which is the same 18650 lithium-ion rechargeable battery. It also comes with a micro USB cable to charge the battery. Lastly, we have the smart bulb, 800 lumens, dimmable, neutral white, A19 LED bulb, which is the medium base bulb and the most popular bulb here in the US, if not around the world. So this is a soft white 3500 Kelvin light. And this soft white light applies to all Ring smart lights. I wish they are bi-color and can go up to 5000 Kelvin. Opening the box, we have the same paperwork and the bulb itself. Time to set this up, which I did get into an issue that I have to call customer service. I kept getting the enabled Bluetooth message even when my Bluetooth is already on. I power cycled my phone and even rebooted the Ring Bridge, but the issue persisted. They're not even able to get to step 2 of the setup. I'll give a shout out to Michael with the Ring technical support, who fixed it by telling me to delete the Ring app and an important step, which is to power cycle my phone before downloading the app again and reinstalling it. With that, my setup went smoothly, so you might want to try it out if you have some issues with your setup. Just follow the prompts on the Ring app to set up your light. Click Setup Device, Smart Lighting, and scan the QR code and wait until your light is connected to the Ring Bridge and firmware updated. The procedure will be the same when setting up all other Ring smart lighting devices. Now, as to the settings in the app, I'll use the solar path light as an example, and the settings should be about the same with the other solar lights. Battery level on the upper right corner. You can turn on or off the light and motion detection. Adjust the brightness. Then there's the events history, which shows everything that happened to the light. Light settings, where you can turn on the light sensor so that it will not activate the light when it senses motion during daytime. And you can adjust the threshold. Then the motion settings, where you can adjust the sensitivity from low, medium, high, or custom. Then link devices, which what makes this light integrate with other Ring devices in your home, like turning on other lights or for Ring cameras to start recording when motion has been detected on this path light. We then have light schedules, which is one thing that differentiates this with their battery-powered counterparts. With this new solar smart lights, you can schedule the lights to turn on and off on a specific time range, and even can be set to turn on dusk till dawn. Then device health, which shows status, signal strength, and battery level. Time to do the installation. First, in the front, we will replace the light bulb on my front porch light. Then on the wall near the steps, I'll install the step light, which for now, I'll use a double-sided mounting tape. Depending on how it performs, I might screw it in eventually to the brick wall for a more permanent install. As to the path light, nothing to it, just stake it to the ground. Just how easy it is to stake down, it will be easier to pull out. So you have to be aware that somebody can just start pulling this out of your front yard. And that is why I only placed two of them leading to my front door, and I placed them in the middle with cameras watching. Just decreasing the chance of somebody pulling them out. Lastly, the solar floodlight. I decided to install this in the same area where I do my outdoor Wi-Fi camera testing, just to have more lighting, and the solar panel under it. The morning sun hits this post would be a great way to charge the floodlight's battery. Now we will come back later on tonight and see how all of these will play out. By the way, this is the new Wiseband, and if you haven't seen my review video yet, I'll link it in the description down below. Turn on backyard floodlights. Alright, so it's already nighttime, and I'm gonna show you guys my backyard setup. I have two of the Ring floodlights. I have the battery version and also the new solar version. And I've linked them together with the solar path light, which I'll show later on. and I've linked all of them. So if one of them detects motion, then the other one will also turn on. And as you can see here, I'm gonna go towards the house and all my backyard lights will turn on. And that includes the two floodlights and also the path light. So I'll be going in and one triggers, and this is my battery floodlight, and see it turned on. And then my solar powered one turned on. And it's also linked to my Ring stick-up cam. Third generation, and it's recording. And let's see what it looks like. It should be in full color. And separately, I have my spotlight, which always have been here. My wife and I, and that's a Kuna floodlight. My wife and I have been doing the garden. And this is where we're gonna put the path light. And also I placed the Mr. Beams right here. I might change that to a solar light, but for now, the path light, if it's working okay, then it will stay here. I'm get another one. And that's how my backyard looks like. On the other side of the house, I have the Ring spotlight, the battery version. And when it triggers, it should also trigger my spotlight cam, a battery version right over there, which has some issue right now because it turned off. It just turned off, but it should be recording. So usually at night, but at 6 o'clock until around midnight, this is what my house would look like. So all my low voltage lighting is turned on and my front porch light is turned on. The post light is a Kuna light and it's separate. So anyways, if I go to the walkway and my Ring path lights will be triggered like so, and it will turn on also that step light right here, and also will trigger the floodlight, and it should be recording, and also my doorbell.
As to all Ring smart lights, the path lights are my least favorite, just because they are easy to steal, and you will need at least a pair and probably more if you want it to work as designed, which to light up the pathway. I do recommend wired low voltage lighting and getting the Ring smart light transformer. It will be way cheaper, more design options, and with steady power because it is wired, and also kind of hard to steal because they are crimped onto the wires. As to the solar powered one, you need this bright sunlit pathway just to keep the battery charged up. But if you have shrubs and trees casting a shadow to the path light solar panel, then it would only light up at night for several hours, and the battery will be dead. As to the floodlight, the solar floodlight is indeed brighter, but I wish Ring should have made their smart lights, and this includes the smart bulbs, by color, so that customers can change it from 3000 Kelvin soft white to 5000 Kelvin white light. Any questions, comment down below. Thanks for watching and I hope you liked this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it yet. And click the bell notification so as to get notified when I upload product reviews and updates like this video, comparison videos, and long-term reviews. Thank you. By the way, there's something wrong with this picture. Not me, something here. If you notice, and the first one to comment what it is, we'll get a $25 Amazon e-gift card. Good luck.